Well, goodbye, fast time clear. I think I just added about 8 hours onto that one. Actually, that was more like six to yeah, 9.5. 9.5 hours is the clear time. You just subtract that later. Ina, stay back. The King's Mount is still alive. Stay back. Ina. No. What's going on? This mound is so calm. Ike, let them be. Seer, what's this all about? That is her mate. As death nears, he has regained his sanity. Kingsdane's mound is Ina's mate. Giant. Questacottle? Hey, that's the name of that bitch from Final Fantasy VIII. Yeah, what is it? Yeah, I think this dragon seems a little too hot. No cars, though. Lagoose. No, it can't be. Ashnar's mount was a wyvern. Wasn't it? Nah, it's totally a dragon, person, thing, whatever. Quetzalcoatl is a person from Final Fantasy VIII, isn't they? Yeah, I know, right? What are you doing? Be patient, please. Something we want to try. Huh? I think this is also hard mode only. It certainly isn't listed anywhere that this happens. Everywhere I've looked on the internet, no one ever mentions this. Racing, that's. Yen told me that the dragon's true form had been warped, so he sang the Gauder of Rebirth. Right? Giant, do you know who I am? Ina. Yes. Yes! You recognize me. To suffer because of me. I'm sorry. Our giant. Ina, let's return to Goldoa. The two of us. Together. I would go anywhere, my love, as long as it's with you. Ina, from this day forward, forever. A giant. He was one of the dragon tribe. That's right. He and Ina were to engage to be married. And then he was driven mad by King Dan, and his form warped. I see. Is that? No, dang. Here it is. What is it, Mist? Did you find something? The medallion, Ike. The medallion. I finally have it back. Mist, that medallion is... Yeah, I know. Grayson, Leanne. The fuck do you want? What? Here. Ooh. This thing is fucking set to turn us mad. The medallion belongs to Serenus Forest. My mother was holding it for Lilia. Leanne, you take it. Now I don't want none of that shit. Thank you, daughter of Elena. In the memory of my departed sister, I accept the medallion from you. And that's that. I seem to recall Rajayan actually surviving. I don't know. Maybe in, like, the actual end game over here where I beat the... Like, in this one, I made What's-His-Face move really fast. And I kicked the shit out of him really fast. So maybe if you do it fast enough, he does survive. I don't think he does. I think I just misinterpreted that scene. Maybe he survives, maybe he doesn't. Because I know the scene in which you use the Garger doesn't actually work in, like, the normal version. I believe you just kill the dragon straight up. I don't know. Maybe I'm completely wrong. Whatever. Point is, you at least don't get the Jesus look at the time. There you go. Just subtract like 9.5 hours from that and you get the actual completion time. And our last time hearing this music. Past year, I've been focused on winning this war. I stand here today as a testament to your fortitude and commitment. I understand this will never suffice, but I wanted to take a moment to say thanks to you all. Thank you. I hope I may continue to rely on you. Of course, I hope that I may continue to be of service. You've grown up so much. It would look nothing better than if Commander Grail and Elena could see you right now. What a long road we've traveled, and yet, in many ways, it seems to pass so quickly. I'm glad it's finally over. We did well, didn't we? I'm sure Mom and Dad would be proud of us. Great job, Ike. Of course, if it hadn't been me by your side the whole time, victory might have slipped away.
Commander Ike, I'm gonna keep practicing so I can be better than ever. Thanks for having faith in me.
Finally. It's finally over. At long last, we can return to a life without war. Praise the goddess.
Ike, are we gonna go back to being mercenaries? I'm a great soldier and all, but, being easygoing life with a mercenary is the only life for me. Now, let's go to find some good-looking lasses. Bah. I suppose you want some kind of congratulations now, right? Too bad. You're snot-nosed whelp, but I'm still better than you. Don't ever forget that.
Hey, boss, we did it! You know, I'm completely in love with your fighting style. If I could train under you, it'd be great. So let me stick around for a while, alright?
No more work here.
I believe in you shortly. If you have need of my services, you know how to reach me.
Call for a fireman.
Lyncia, you've had to wait a long time, but I finally fulfilled my contract. The mission is complete.
My Lord Ike, on behalf of all Crimea and my departed father, mother, and uncle, I thank you once again.
Oh, stop. Come on, will you please stop doing that?
Pardon?
I think I've gotten used to a few of these noble customs and whatnot, but I still can't handle the bowing bit. It makes me antsy, and itchy, too.
Oh, my Lord Ike.
Oh, glorious, sweet day of victory. Praise upon the day the goddess did see fit to send Sir Ike to save our land.
Thank you, General Ike. Because of you, I believe we better understand how better to serve Princess Alencia.
Through your strength, the dark clouds that blanketed Crimea have been dispelled. From this day forth, we will give our all to see the restoration of this land and its people. General, you are Crimea's savior. For your meritous service, I salute you. Huzzah! Nay, 1,000 huzzahs! Whew! Am I glad that's over. When I saw King Dan, I was sure was done for. Or that he'd torture me. But you were a bull. Thank you. Now I can go home and see my family once again.
When I get back to the countryside, I'm gonna bust all my family and friends that I fought under you. Largo and I are going to stay here and open up a shop.
With Crimea underground reconstruction, there are gonna be a lot of people moving around. We'll open up an inn with good food and drink, and free butter on every table. I'll be rich in no time.
I'll let you know when everything's all set up. You can drop in any time.
We even give you special rates. Maybe we should call General Ike's in.
General Ike, I will be taking my leave of you for the time being. I must return to Bedyon and present a report on the war's outcome. Aren't you going to take Bedyon's soldiers with you? You lost quite a few. Though the war may be over, it will take many weeks to see the country secure. I spoke with the princess earlier, and she asked that we help if possible, so I'll leave them in your care for a while longer. We really do owe Bedyon a lot, don't we? In the end, we got not only you, but a whole battalion of reinforcements. General Zalgius and his troops are the reason we were able to minimize casualties during the final battle. He and his men took care of the retreating Dayan and allowed us to focus on the enemies before us. But no matter the assistance you had, the victory itself is as a result of your strength and leadership. I know two people will be very pleased to learn of your triumph. Please give my thanks to both the Apostle and Sephiroth. I plan to go and thank them myself someday, but understood. Farewell, General Ike. I look forward to seeing you again. Farewell.
Hey, Ike, handsome. I decided to return to service in the Bedyon Peasants. Now there. Jesus Christ. Cool beans, huh? Oh, I owe you so much, Ike. Thank you so very much. See you around.
I think I may try to start over in Bedyon. Maybe it's too much, too soon. But I just want to live a more responsible life. Plus, I'm tired of men threatening to break my knees. Goodbye, Ike.
Goodbye, General Ike. This war has given me the confidence to enter the service of the Bedyon Knights. Thank you so much.
Devdan is glad all the fighting stopped. Devdan prefers the peace and quiet. War is not good for anything.
Well, we're going home. All of our desert friends are waiting for us. And wow, do we have some stories to share with them.
Who's in Bjork? Perhaps the gap between us has narrowed. War is horrible. Yet, maybe we gain something of value, after all.
Find me when you come to the dunes. You can sit and talk with no fighting.
Are you leaving already?
Yep, I'm out of here. I've got some important guests to convey to the king.
Guests?
You know, I'm gonna eat some serious Lagoon's cuisine.
He's talking about us. We're taking my father to visit Gallia for a while. We Heron should live somewhere near a forest, after all. Tabarn spoke with King Cagnus on our behalf. You're not returning to Serenus? While we made our peace with the Apostle, we're not ready to live there again. I see. You'll be able to return someday. Bjork and Lagoon's will come to understand and respect each other. Be right. I hope you are.
Are you ready? We should be leaving soon.
Gifka, I'm in your debt as well. Gal is a very special place to me. I'd like to visit again someday, if I may.
Come ever whenever you are able. The king will be pleased to see you. And one more thing. Gallia will not spare any effort in aiding Crimea's reconstruction. We will be sending supplies and workers to you shortly. That is much appreciated.
Oh, wait, Rayson, Leanne.
What is it?
Do you think I could touch the medallion one last time? For my mom and dad?
Yeah, sure. Can you just, like, take the medallion with you?
Of course. Go ahead, put your hand on it. All right. Thank you very much.
Is that enough?
Yes. I just wanted to say goodbye.
Thank you.
Hmm?
And you too, Ike.
What?
And I'd also like to give a heartfelt thanks to your parents as well for fulfilling the hopes of our sister. Thank you. No, seriously, you can have this medallion. I don't actually want it.
Yes.
Ike, I will help rebuild Crimea too. I will lend you much strength.
I don't know when, but if that thing we talked about happened, I would be fine. I guess. Not that I care.
So, goodbye. That's what happens from the A support. She gets all Sundere. Plenty of the dairy in there. Well, it's about time I up and take wing. We've built quite a close bond, haven't we? This is true. We're especially grateful for your help in Serenus Forest. The next time you're visiting the southern coast, come to Phoenicius. Your entire country will celebrate your arrival. Country of the Hawk Tribe, eh? That'd be fun. I'm interested in what type of kind of food you have to eat. We collect berries from trees on peaks that no Bjork can climb. Juices and desserts made are from, made from air are beyond compare. We have ocean delicacies, mountain treats. We have everything. I'll pass on the desserts. They'll take extra help with the meat. Leave it to me. I hate to interrupt your gleeful chat, but I thought I should tell you. You don't have to visit Kilvas. It's our policy not to invite Bjork into our home. Unless they pay well. Ah, King Kilvas. Despite all your posturing, you come to our aid in the end. You turned out to be a better ally than I dared hope for. Ah, keep your foolish tongue inside your foolish head. And don't tell anyone. I have a reputation to think of. Farewell. And I'm serious about Phoenicius, too. Come anytime. General, the bird tribes are in your debt. We are grateful. Please, take care.
If you ever need a hot king's eyes, fire a flaming arrow from a high place. I'll see it and come flying.
That is, if I'm not busy on an errand from the king. And of course, Dan. We're missing one person. I'm sorry. We're missing a certain Zyhark, but oh well. Close enough.
General Ike, I will never, ever forgive you.
I will never forgive you. Forget you.
Thank you for showing me the error in my ways.
I'm just glad that it's finally over. Maybe now I can get some sleep.
Things are going to be rough in Dan, too. I don't know what the future holds, but I'm heading back. It's my homeland, after all.
I have played my part. All that remains is for me to take my leave of this place. History will judge my actions.
Mustin and the others are going to Dan, and I think I'm going to go with them. Thank you for everything, General Ike. I hope they packed enough food. I'm pretty hungry.
How about, Ina? We've been both enemies and allies.
Thanks to you, Rachayan was saved. And so was I. Thank you.
So you're with King Dan because you were trying to save Rachayan?
Yes.
Ina's fiancé went missing many years ago. After Ina found him, she came to me for help. She told me that Rachayan was with King Dan and that he had been warped almost beyond recognition. Long ago, Ina's parents died, and I was unable to do anything for her. Even so, she still came to me for help. No matter what, I had to help her. It was to that end that I used you. I am so sorry. It's all in the past now. There's nothing for you to worry about any longer. Thank you, Ike. Will Ina return to Goldoa?
Yes. We must take Rajayan back to his hometown.
We? Are you going to Nazir? Yes, I am.
for the first time in decades, a walk on Gildoan soil. That'll be nice. Take care of yourself. And give my regards to Kuthnaga.
I will. Until we meet again.
Nazir. Hmm? I don't know what you thought, but I always trusted you. Except for that one moment when you learned of your deception, I never thought of you as an enemy. Even now you defy my prediction. Prediction? When we were sailing off the coast of Phoenicia, remember? I said that war would change how you look at things. And yet, through all that's happened, you've remained the same. I just can't pretend to be anything I'm not. Never been any good at that. Please stay that way, Ike. Don't change for anyone. I'll see you again, won't I? Yes. I'm sure of it. And that's that. So, what they were saying there, they gotta take Rajayan back to his hometown. I don't know if that means he's dead or alive. I think that means he's dead. Take his body back to be buried there. Or take him alive back. I don't know. Also, someone should watch that dog.
The war is over. The Crimean people, who suffered gravely during the harsh day in occupation. Jesus, this text is too slow. Have at last regained their freedom. These same Crimeans have a saying. No matter how harsh the winter, spring will ever follow. This popular proverb proves true as the warm winds of change begin to blow across the countryside. The war has left the country in ruins, but the people rise from the ashes and take the first steps towards rebuilding their nation. Though once scorned and despised as subhumans, the Laguz put aside past enmity, and come to their aid as their neighbors.
They got some sumo wrestlers up there.
And the Crimeans never forgot it was Galia that fought beside them and helped free them from the yoke of Daean oppression. Led by the examples of Alincia and her retainers, Crimea begins transforming into the land its king had dreamed of. A land where Bjork and the Goos lived together in harmony and equality. As the reconstruction efforts progress, the administrative government announces the enthronement of Alincia as the new queen. And now, the day of her crowning arrives.
Chapter End Game 2, Alincia's crown. Now, we're done. Fight off all the people who want to take the crown from Alincia. Nah, that's the next game. Don't worry about that. Sort of.
I'm so tired I could fall over. This is all well and good, but it sure is busy.
We're rebuilding a country that was completely devastated by war. It's bound to be tough.
You're right. But Princess Alincia and the people in the palace are twice as busy.
Speaking of Alincia, what's she doing?
She's in that room over there, surrounded by court officials. They seem really busy. I feel so sorry for her.
As long as she's getting at least a little sleep, a little bit of rest, I'm not worried. But she probably isn't.
Maybe if I sang her a lullaby. Oh no, I forgot.
Forgot what?
I gave the medallion back to Raisin, but I forgot all about the Galder. Like, what should we do?
Hey, yeah.
We never did find out who Altina is, did we? She was the only one who could sing the Galder.
Well, when things calm down, we'll have to head out and
search for her.
Is that Altina you speak of? One of the three who defeated the Dark God? Hey! Severin!
So you made it, did you?
I arrived mere moments ago. Let me congratulate you on a successful end to your journey.
Thank you. Please, tell me, do you know who Altina is?
Of course. Altina founded my homeland of Begnion.
Oh, then it was a mistake. You can't give a song to somebody who's died so long ago.
There is one who yet shares both bloodline and name. The true heir of Altina.
Who is it?
Sanaki Kirst Altina. None other than the Apostle herself.
The Apostle? Is this something everyone in Begnion would be aware of?
No. There are very few who know that name.
Why do you ask? The Apostle is Altina.
Oh, I'm so relieved. And exhausted, too. Ike, I'm going back to my room. See you later, Sephiran.
That was rather sudden. Did I say something to cause her distress?
No, nothing like that. It's just that so much has happened between Begnion and Serenus.
Would you tell me about it? I would hear what you have to say on this matter.
Sure. To tell the truth...
I see. The assassination of the Apostle, the Serenus Massacre, and the use of the medallion to revive the Dark God. All of it is part of Ashnard's grand scheme.
That's the conclusion we came to.
You have me at a loss.
Why is that?
For many years, I have walked these lands, watching, listening. Never did I uncover what you have found. Now that you have presented me with this information, I don't know what to say.
I merely fulfilled the hopes of my father and mother.
Now you speak from hindsight. Rescuing Princess Crimea, winning the Apostle's trust, and defeating King Dan. With the goose at your side, no less. You have accomplished all of these miraculous things.
I had trusted and valiant companions on my side. It was only through their support that I was able to do these things.
Ever the humble one, eh? Now then, before I return home, may I hear the Gauldron of Release? I must convey it to the Apostle.
You would do that?
None of you can leave Crimea. The new queen will need you strength.
Your strength, but I suppose that'll be the case for a little while, won't it?
A little while. You are the hero of Crimea, General-like. If you wish it, no post will be beyond your reach.
I don't care about any of that. It's more trouble than it's worth. And I don't see the value of being some fancy lord. When the country's safe, I'm giving up that title and everything. I'm going back to being a simple mercenary. Truly. You are... Is something strange?
Yes. It's very...
I think that's enough.
I'm so sorry.
Unbelievable. Despite all appearances, you're really quite rude.
Commander, may I have a minute?
Sure. What is it, Titania?
Princess Alencia. It's Queen Alencia, isn't it? The court ministers want Queen Alencia and you to come back onto the balcony and greet the people.
What? Greet the people? Me?
Yes, you.
I've done what I was asked to do. Now hurry up and get going. Hey, Titania. Ah, nuts. What's going on?
The people of Crimea wish to see their hero and to sing his praises, even if the hero himself protests.
If they want a greeting, I'm sure their new Queen Alencia would suffice. I'll go speak to her.
Thus, do heroes give birth to new chapters in history. I doubt if you've ever noticed. Your story, the everyday mercenaries who became a hero, will awaken ugly appetite and ambition in many. It will be the cause of strife and discord throughout the land. I'm certain Ashnard saw the truth in this. In a way, Ashnard's dream may have been fulfilled. The seeds of war have indeed been sown across the continent. It appears that your trials are just beginning, my gallant young hero. May the goddess ride with you.
And one final cutscene.
What's wrong? Everyone's waiting to see you.
I'm nervous. I've spent my whole life in hiding. It's just no one ever taught me how to rule a kingdom. I don't think I'm ready to be their queen. I don't think I'm ever really going to be ready.
What's the matter with you?
Ike, stop it. How can I...
Did anyone teach you how to hire mercenaries?
No, but that's not the same.
How to win back lost allies? How to win back your lost kingdom?
That's different.
No, it's not. You've done such an amazing job, and I think you always will.
I see.
All right. Come on. We'll do this. Together.
Thank you, my Lord Ike. I am so blessed to have met you.
And so it was that in the spring of the year 646, Alencia Rydell Crimea saw peace return to her homeland.
Oh.
In the years to follow, a story of Queen Alencia and her noble hero Ike spread across the land and inspired the songs of many a wandering troubadour.
Staff credits, everybody. That's it. That is the end of Fire Emblem Path of Radiance. Been one hectic upload session. Where the hell did I start this project? I need to go look that up, except if I do, I'm gonna, like, block out the screen.
Apologies for 1 second. Whoop. There you go. Now I have all my side screen. This is why it's nice to have a second screen. Let's go look the shit up. Ah, shit. I don't have the internet. Let's pop that up and put on the internet. Got to keep it off for Camtasia because Camtasia's an asshat. Actually, it's sort of me being the asshat and not paying for Camtasia, but you know. Bossrosslp, Path of Radiance. Not that one. There we go. August 9th, 2016. So this has been a long ongoing project. Today is the 11th of January. Today is the day I realized that school actually starts a lot earlier than I thought it did. Starts on Tuesday, coming up, so the 17th, which is fantastic. But, well, whatever with that. So this has been an awesome project. It was a lot of fun running this game with all girls. It was not nearly what I would consider a challenge. It was more like a gimmick, because really it wasn't a challenge at all. To be perfectly honest, this is definitely one of the Fire Emblem games in which an all-females run is not hard in the slightest. Some of the Fire Emblem games would be really challenging with an all-females run, such as Fire Emblem 6. In that game, you do not get a female until the second chapter. And that's a healer, and you also get a Pegasus Knight, so good fucking luck doing an all-girls run of that. I had to cheat with Ike, so I guess you could do an all-girls run and Roy in that one, and it would be fair. I don't know what you do for Fire Emblem 7. I guess you just wouldn't use Eliwood and Hector. And for Fire Emblem 8, I guess you could use Erica, and the next girl you get is, Naomi would be the next girl you get, which is not bad. Yeah, Fire Emblem 8 would be very doable. You could probably solo a couple of the first chapters with just Erica. You'd have to turtle a lot, but it'd be possible. Then once you get people like Naomi, and then you get people like Lute. Once you get Lute, you basically win. Lute's fucking overpowered in that game. But that was Path of Radiance. This is still my favorite Fire Emblem game. I just feel like the inclusion of Lagoos, the inclusion of somewhat good difficulty without, like, insane, annoying to get through difficulty, like in 13 and 14, that just makes you want to play in, like, casual mode. So you don't have to restart the chapter every fucking 5 turns. It's fun. You still feel like you can get some powerful units, but not like they can solo the whole game. Unless it's Ike. If it's Ike, you can totally solo the whole game. I don't know, just the map design, the music I love. The story is awesome. This is probably my favorite Fire Emblem story. Just like elements like that really make this game very memorable. And I don't know if it's worth the $90 that it's being sold for on eBay. It's a bit of a shame that this game has gotten so expensive over the years, but I think that means a good thing. It means it's a good game. It's well worth a high price, considering how fun it is and how much you can get out of it. You get a pretty good story. Like, I got 40 hours playing by myself out of this game. So you get a pretty good story. Of course, I'm slow with my preparation, so that could explain it. And again, subtract the 9.5 hours from that. And yeah, these are just the staff credits. After the staff credits, we do not get the usual Fire Emblem scene where it tells what happened to everyone after the story. That comes in Radiant Dawn, because Radiant Dawn is the continuation of this, and it sort of assumes that everyone survived. More importantly, however, we get something very nice, and it is a stat total that tells you who is the unit that participated the most in battles. And it sort of ranks all your units in terms of how many battles and wins they participated in. Which is nice, because we'll be able to see who our top 5 most used units were. I'm very curious to see who it is. To make an estimation right now, I'm going to say Ike is probably first. Titania is definitely in the top 5. I would say that Marcia is likely in the top 5. Ileana probably won't be, because even though she's been used a lot, she goes from a range. Mist is probably going to be there in the top 5. Well, maybe. She got in less combat. I don't know, actually. Is it starting? No, just some music. Oh, this is where they finally give you some subtitles to it. Yep. Oh, there's Naomi. Not the same Naomi, and it was Naomi in the same place, in the same case, whatever. See, absolutely fantastic. If you can get your hands on this game, I definitely recommend it. If you love Fire Emblem, this is my favorite, so. Question is, what Fire Emblem game are we going to be doing next? Well, it's going to be a long time before I do a Fire Emblem game again. I'm not sure which one I would do next. I did the GBA games. I guess maybe a redo of 7? I don't know. I wouldn't even count that as a Fire Emblem game. I'd probably, like, speed through it. I don't even know. Like, 7's the only one I'd like to go back and redo. If I tried to redo any of the other ones, I would just skip the story and add, like, a challenge to it. Like, a randomizer or a pick my edits run. Something like that. I guess technically the next new one I need to do is Radiant Dawn, in a way. I've never played it. I have no idea how much it is online. How much I'd have to pay to get Radiant Dawn. Probably a lot. Probably nothing that's worth spending the money on. Plus, Radiant Dawn is hard as shit, if I remember correctly. Because they fucked up with the difficulty. This game's hard mode, it feels like normal mode. And that game's hard mode feels like very hard, and normal mode feels like hard mode, so that'll be fun to go through. Of course, some people will be like, oh, it's not that hard, you get saves after the end of every turn. And that's true, you do get saves. You get a shitload of saves, because you can save mid-turn. It's a little broken, and you can reload that save too. If you die, you can just reload that. So I might not use those, because that just sounds a little overpowered. I'm not sure who this other female is that's singing. Guess they sort of gave up the whole idea of only having one other female Laguz. I don't know. And again, I don't know what happened with Rajan. I have no idea if he's actually alive. I think he's dead. I'm not certain. I mean, there was lines like he was a dragon, so I guess that sort of implies that he's died, but I don't know. I think he's dead. Maybe he is, maybe he isn't. She didn't seem overly upset when we were talking to her later, but she's kind of a stoic, strong character. I don't know. Either way, that's that. What a ridiculous game. Honestly, I think playing with all females actually helped, because it ensured that I used a lot of good units. And I think I've changed my mind about how a lot of units are. Like, maybe I wouldn't even call Nefany a 10 out of 10 anymore. She did pretty good, but she got hit a lot. I mean, she dodged like a fiend and crit like a pro, but I don't know. Mist, I'm still happy about Mist. Mist turned out fantastic. Ileana turned out better than I expected. I don't know what the fuck happened to her growth, but something happened. Got a very blessed Ileana. Of course, you have to rate units based on, like, not only how good they can grow, but how useful they are. And in that case, I guess Titania would be a much higher rating. Because she is a very useful unit for getting you through the early game if you have an all-girls run and Ike. But either way, it's time to rank our units. Here we go. Finn. And that's Path of Radiance. Come on. Come on, give me the screen. I want to see it. Here we go. The records. So we beat mercenaries really fast. We did that on purpose to get some bonus experience. Luckily, you don't have to wait around for support, so a lot of these turn counts are actually going to be pretty reasonable. Pirates of Ground took way longer than it should have. Yeah, Brief Diversion took a little bit of time. Shades of Evil took a lot of time. Sparing Hope, there's no way to beat it faster, so that's good. Prisoner Released, we took extra long on because we tried to make everyone escape. Everything else seems like it's pretty reasonable turn counts. We didn't do bad. Now, we took 2 hours for 14 turns? What the fuck happened there? Okay. Daybreak's only 29 turns? That's all 4 of those, so that's pretty damn good. How did we take 6 hours on it? I guess I left the game on. Good job, Ross. And of course, the final chapter in which I believe we did 11 hours. Yeah, don't worry about that. That's me. Just subtract a good 9.5 hours from that and you get the actual time I took on repatriation. repatriation, whatever. Well, no, pretty reasonable. And the unit records. Zyhark, the only guy to die. Oscar, he got the shit pushed out of him. Boy, didn't do much. I think he carried somebody. Ryze, you were literally worthless. Shinon, you got drunk in that what cutscene. Gotri, yeah, I don't know, you did something. Soren, I kept shitting on you every single time you told me my unit ranking. Rolf, you were snot-nosed brat. Mordecai, you were someone easy to do the voice of because it didn't hurt me. Volk, you're fucking hilarious in all your cutscenes. Kieran, you're also pretty funny in all your cutscenes. Brom, I think I went the farthest with yours next to Devdan in terms of voice acting. Makalov, you're a lovable goon. Stefan, thank you for the occult scroll. I gave it to Ike, I believe. Tormod, you're a shit-nosed brat. Wareham, you're kind of a really cool character. Devdan do good. Devdan did pretty good. Racen, I wish I could have used you. Oki and Janaf, I don't wish I could have used you. Thank God I didn't have to. All boys run. Torino, you're a boss. I wish I could have used your resolve, but it lived on in Effany. Renolf, you're pretty sweet, but, you know, eh. Har, I would have loved to use Har. Bastion. And, of course, there's Largo. Nazir, I never got to use. This does not show Ina. Soth, you were pretty useful in stealing everything. Joffrey, oh wow, Joffrey got a kill on player phase. There's Alencia at the very end there. Lucia, Tanith, Khalil. Here we are. You get to see the wins. Mist is not in the top five. Mia's not in the top five. Jill's not in the top five. I didn't think she would be. Aslid's not in the top five. How did that happen? Alright, so that means our top five is going to be very interesting. Let's see what happens. Who is our top five? Ileana is in the top five. Damn. Marcia, I called that. I'm assuming Titan's gonna be two. Nephany is third? Holy shit, man. Dude, she did pull out then. There's Titania. And of course, Lord Ike with fucking 189 wins. I destroy everything. And that's it. That is Fire Emblem Path of Radiance. Blame the fact that our number two candidates were from the Ike and Titania play Path of Radiance for seven chapters. Yum yum. That's it. Ileana, Marcia, Nephany, Titania, and Ike. You were the five MVPs, I guess. Though I would consider Aslid an MVP, too. She was in the top six. And Jill up there. Yep. All our girls were in there. Lindsay did not get many kills, but she was still useful with her healing. And that's it. For realsies, that is the end of Path of Radiance. Just restarts. Alright, well, I guess that just leaves the trial maps that I'm not going to be doing. Oh, I accidentally saved over it. Oh well, there's our glorious 59 time limit. So here are the maps. You actually get some new maps if you input through the Game Boy connector. If you put in Fire Emblem, you get new maps. I believe Lonely Isle we got. I don't know what else we got. Some stuff. So there are some trial maps. And basically, like, it gives you small stories. Yep. Hmm. I wonder if they actually do have stories. They're more just like trial maps. They don't really do much, but they're pretty fun. I've played them before. They're not too challenging, from what I remember. Mm-hmm. Good thing Dan's soldiers forgot to take away their weapons. Yeah, that's really smart of them. Either way, you can now look at your nice illustrations from everybody in the game. You've seen everybody. I think. Yeah. Oh, there is someone we haven't seen. Who the hell is that? Oh, that's probably Gifka. That's totally Gifka. Gifka's the only person that hasn't appeared. Wow. I ironically screwed myself. If I just called Gifka, I would have had his portrait here. Oh, well. There's Ina. I guess Gifka is the only person you don't actually see as a unit unless you summon him. Because we got Nysala and Tybarn because they just naturally appear. These are what I've been using for the character bios. I haven't personally recorded them myself. I just went and found the pictures. Anyway, we also have, wait, what? What on earth? Why is Effie Path of Radiance down there twice? That's weird. Yeah, Path of Radiance is down there twice. Wait, why can't I go to the other Path of Radiance? Ah, just like the Mirror World Path of Radiance. Anyway, I also input Fire Emblem, so you get to see all these characters. Hey, remember these guys? I really should do a redo of Fire Emblem 7. Hey, this tells me what would happen if I did an all-females run. So I guess I'd start with Lynn. I'd get Florina. I'd get Sarah, which would be fine. Then I'd be screwed for a little while, because Lucius is also a boy. Yeah, it would just be those three, beating the whole game of the first 10 chapters. Then it would unfortunately be Rebecca all by herself. All by herself until Priscilla in chapter 14. I don't even know if that's possible. She'd break her iron bow before she'd even get there. And then once I get Priscilla, what happens? I'm stuck until Fiora. Priscilla and... No, Rebecca would still be all by herself until fucking chapter 19, I think. No, that's 18. That's... No. 17? No, that's 18. She'd be stuck by herself until 18. She would be the most insane unit I've ever used. Then I'd get Ninian, which would be good. Isidore, oh my god, Isidore would be my pal. Oh wait, no, some of the characters would come back. So that means Rebecca would come back with, she'd get Sarah. Sarah would be a comeback character. Florina would come back with Lynn, so I'd get those guys back at the same time. So I guess it'd really be screwed until chapter 13, like, until chapter 15, I'd be screwed. I don't even know if that'd be physically possible. I guess I could just say I can use Ike, or I could use Eliwood and Hector, but I still feel like that's cheating. I do get, Isadora, or not Isadora, Louise, I mean. Hot-ass Louise over there, that would work. I would also get Nino. Dude, the girls in this game are actually kind of terrible. Like, there are much better guys. I could also get Farina if I did, Hector's playthrough, which would help. I don't know. Sexy Sonya over there, not wearing, like, any leg covering. Hey, I could get Layla. She's a character, right? That's playable. Yeah, Fire Emblem would be fucking hard with an all-girls run. I don't know if I could do it. I mean, maybe I could. I could see if someone's actually done it before. I assume if anyone's done it, they've did it with Eliwood and Hector allowed. Or at least Eliwood allowed. Or whoever's storyline they're playing. I definitely wouldn't do hard mode if that was the case. I'd do hard mode for Lynn, but then I would do normal mode for Eliwood, because a hard mode Eliwood isn't even fun. It really isn't. It doesn't make the game too much harder. It just makes it so you can't select as many units, which just isn't fun to me. Also, you get less items, which kind of blows. It makes the game just not fun to play. So maybe I'll do an all-girls run of Fire Emblem. I would probably have to redo the storyline and do all the characters again, because that was the second Let's Play I ever did, if you don't know. That was back in 2011 that I did that Let's Play. That was almost 6 years ago. Oh, Jesus, it's been a long time. Actually, that was... How many years has it been?
That's 6 years ago.
Yeah, it's 6 years ago. I'm an old man, guys. That was 6 fucking years ago. Right, 2011, so 2012, 13, 14, 15, 16, yeah. That was a whole year ago. Year and 2 months, about. Year and 3 months, maybe. Jesus. Well, that's Path of Radiance. Thank you guys so much for watching. When we come back next time for whatever we're doing, it's not going to be Fire Emblem. It's going to be moving on, because with this, I'm done this. I'm done Corpse Party, and I'm done something else. Something else that was important for me to get done that I'm done. Well, no, I'm still doing U-Realms. I guess that's not done, but that won't be done for a long time, because that's still ongoing with Zuper and Jaden and whoever our fourth person is. Occasionally it's Wolf, occasionally it's nobody. Actually, more often than that, it's nobody. But we did have a couple of maps with Wolf. But yeah, coming up next is going to be the next Phoenix Wright game. In the list I need to do that, and I don't know what to do on the side of that. I don't know what I'm doing with Anne. I'll figure that all out. I'm thinking about Valkyria Chronicles. I'm not certain. That would be a blind playthrough. A totally blind playthrough, mind you. I've seen screenshots. That's all I've seen. I literally have no idea what the fuck it is. I also saw the intro, so it seems like it's one of those games that's strategy? It said that's Fire Emblem with guns, so I don't know if it would be smart to go from Fire Emblem to Fire Emblem with guns. I don't know. What else would I do? I guess I could do Final Fantasy 13. Ah, that's a good one, Ross. That's a knee slapper. That's a dick slapper right there. Go look at the gaming shelf. I don't know. There's a couple games I could do on the PS3. A couple games I could do on the Wii U. I don't know if I want to do any super long games now. Because I don't think... Well, no, Phoenix Wright will be pretty long. But I'll be able to record those in big settings. So that's okay. Who knows?
Later, y'all.